So, dear friends, we are discussing regarding the biochemic system since last 4-5 lectures, in fact 6-7 lectures, biochemic system of medicine, and we have learned the 5 remedies along with the complete theory of the Schussler regarding the biochemic remedies or 12 tissue remedies. Here one important thing which I want to discuss with you, that all after reading all those 5 remedies or after learning through 5 remedies, what we have learned, how to apply them clinically, that is my specific thought, is that in your practice you should be able to apply them very easily. So just a revision, so this is nothing but the clinical quest come revision. We'll discuss the 10 cases, short cases, single sentence cases, and what will be your thought, what you will be going to think about them, so that it will be a good revision for you how to apply the remedies in such types of cases. And then we'll go ahead for the remaining part of the relationships of 3 remedies which was not discussed yesterday. So before that, we'll just go through these 10 cases. Yeah, I won't answer from you that for all the cases, those who are practicing with our approach, they should not discuss. But those who are new for the biochemic system of medicine, they should answer this question. So a 65 years farmer comes to you with severe lumbar backache, with a severe right sciatica. So what will be your approach? Just write down your remedies in the group chat so that we'll discuss. So what you are going to prescribe with biochemic? Yes, from Jitendra Patel, Calcarea Fluor, anything else? Yes, Calcarea Fluor, definitely. Anything else? Yes, Calcarea Fluor and 26. Why? Because here you don't have to just remove the spondylosis. Patient comes to you with a pain, sciatica, so you will require Calcarea Fos, Calcarea Fluor, Mac Fos. These are the remedies, Kali Fos. So when you think in that way, you must think of the biocombination 26. That will be a simple answer to that. So logic, when you will try applying your logic, then you will come to a conclusion of a remedy very easily, and you can immediately start with the remedies. Don't hesitate whether I should give or I should not give, what will happen. Start using, because if you want to produce very early result, these are the remedies. Second question is, a small child of 5 to 6 years brought to you with a fever since last 1 hour. Yes. It's simple now. Now everyone knows it is Ferrum Fos. Not number
Ferrum Fos.
Number 11, we have not yet discussed. Please keep your audio. So simple thing is that you have to give a Ferrum Fos first stage of inflammation. So naturally, remedy is the first stage of inflammation is a Ferrum Fos. A 13 years girl comes to you with right earache with mucoid discharge. So what will you will require?
Calcarea Fluor.
Think over it, just. It is not. Yes, Kalimur is definitely, but Kalimur will take care of the discharge. What about earache? So you will require the Ferrum Fos along with Ferrum Fos with Kalimur, basically. The remedies which we have discussed. I am not discussing the remedies which we have not yet discussed. And I'm asking you only biochemic remedies, 5 remedies which we have learned up till now. I'm not thinking of the remedies which we have not discussed. So think in right direction, that for pain and inflammation, first stage, second stage, both covers with Ferrum Fos and Kalimur. So these 2 remedies should be there in your prescription. Then fourth, case of severe toothache with caries. toothache with caries, very important thing. Caries is always dental caries, Calcarea pleure, very important remedy. But along with Calcarea pleure, if there is a toothache, you will require the ferrum floss, the Calcarea floss, then even MAC floss, which we have not yet discussed. Yes, that is the remedy. Then a case of traumatic knee edema. Traumatic knee edema. So possibility is there, definitely an effusion. So whenever there is an effusion, so there will be infusion. There is a, basically you will require remedy Calimiraticum. Yes, very important. This is how you have to think logically. A case of acute sore throat with congested tonsils on examination. So sore throat patient comes to you with severe sore throat since 2-3 hours and with congested tonsil. Your simple answer to this is ferrum phosphoricum. Yes. A case of acute headache with coryza. So headache is there associated with the coryza. So here you will require ferrum phosphoricum plus nasal discharge. You think about the Calimiraticum. These are two remedies which should be there. Then a case of non-union of fracture. Think about it. Non-union of fracture. Yes, it is simple that Calcarea pleure plays very vital role. A case of boil on extremities with jaundice. So which is the salt which is there in the liver which metabolizes? Yes, Calcarea salt. Yes, it is Calcarea salt. So this is how you have to apply your logic. This is simple thing which we have discussed. Last, a case of congested face with anemia and bony weakness. So what may be the answer? Congested face with anemia and bony weakness. So ferrum floss plus Calcarea floss, both are needed for that purpose. So you will require ferrum floss because both takes part in the formation of or in the process of anemia. So this is how we have to think. This is the logic. And you can use very, very easily. You can repeat. It never causes any trouble while repeating. And that's why you can handle such types of cases with biochemic remedies. Okay. We'll go ahead with yesterday's remaining part about the thing, that is the relationship of three remedies which we have not discussed. So we'll learn about the Calcarea salt, then ferrum floss and Calimur, because all these remedies are very important and their correlation between the other remedies is also important. So we'll go ahead with the next, Calcarea salt. Homeopathic data, the Calcarea salt was proved by Dr. Conant. The proving appeared in the Transaction of the American Journal Institute of Homeopathy in 1873. It is also to be found in Allen's Encyclopedia, Volume 2, page number 410. Nothing specially characteristic appears in this proving. The guiding symptoms, that is hearing guiding symptoms, on page number 227, have given detailed arrangement of the symptom. So Calcarea salt you can get over there. Then administration, how to administer, and this is again a remedy which can be administered locally. So this remedy is also useful externally in such affections as phelons, ulcers and abscesses. So skin elements where the discharge is generally yellowish and it is perspiration associated with jaundice, think about the Calcarea salt first. The most common potencies for internal use are the 6x and 12x. Low potencies are also useful in purulent eye troubles. Homeopathic relationship. Now, these things, please give time to read this homeopathic relationship, which Schussler have made. See, sentence by sentence, these are very important. Calcarea salt resembles Heparin salt. Yes, they are very close to each other, but acts deeper and more intensely and is often useful after Heparin has ceased to act. So Calcarea salt is further ahead than the heparcelph. If your heparcelph, you have given heparcelph and it ceased to act, it never produced the complete desired result, you should follow it with the calcareous cell. These are practical hints. You write it down one by one on your notes so that if you read them again and again, it becomes fixed in your mind. It is also useful when Kalimur ceases to act. Why? Because Kalimur is the second stage of inflammation. The third stage of inflammation starts right from the calcareous cell. So after Kalimur, calcareous cell. After Ferrumpus, Kalimur. So stages, first stage Ferrumpus, second stage Kalimur, third stage calcareous cell. Third stage, next part is the Kali cell and then is the cilicia. Apocynum contains calcareous cell. See, this is very important. What he says, apocynum itself contains calcareous cell. Compare calendula in suppuration. So compare calcareous cell with calendula, because calendula acts locally in suppurations. So both remedies can be useful. Calendula you can apply locally in wounds, and if there is a suppuration internally, give the calcareous cell and it works really well. Kalimur is the in milk crust and other skin affections, swollen cheek, crow, dysentery. So compare the calcareous cell with Kalimur. Generally, Kalimur, there is a plastic exudate, and if it becomes pustular, think of a calcareous cell, the next stage of inflammation. Same is true whenever there is crow. Crow is a discharge, pharyngeal discharge, which happens to be there, and dysentery. Natrum self in post scarlatina dropsy. So compare the calcareous self with the natrum self in post scarlatina dropsy. So post scarlatina means after the scarlet fever or eruptive fever, if there is a dropsy, that means it affects the kidneys. Think of the calcareous self after the natrum self never work. Cilicia in hard and suppurating glands, ulcers of the cornea, tonsillitis, mastitis, frostbite. Generally, if it is superficial inflammation associated with boils, associated with pus or streptococcal-like infection is there, think of a calcareous cell. If deep-seated abscesses are there, that means there is a sinus is there and it abscess is more inside. Cilicia plays a very vital role. Here, calcareous cell never plays a role. So, cilicia is way ahead in the formation of abscesses. So, hard glands with suppurative glands, suppurations with lymph nodes, associated with lymph nodes, silica plays a very vital role. I have just 2 months back, I have a case, young girl, she was just about to marry and she had a breast abscess, and breast abscess, it was not healing after she had already treated with lot of antibiotics, and till antibiotic was going on, it was settled. She was operated it twice and not getting settled, and she came for treatment, and after continuous treatment with the cilicia 6x and local calendula for the abscess, it healed completely and there is no further recurrence. So this is, cilicia is internal. When the abscess is deep seated, cilicia plays a very vital role. Then ulcers of the cornea. Yes, keratitis. If you open the boric, he mentions over there, if the corneal opacity is there because of ulceration, use cilicia in 30th for months together. He says like that. That is hint given in italics, in borics, whatever. These are the practical hints. Because there is no treatment for corneal opacity. What is the treatment in allopathy? There is only one treatment in allopathy, that is corneal transplant. Because opacity cannot be cured with any other remedy. We have a remedy. It is our, we have to use, and we have to use all those hints given by boric. You open the boric, I'm quite sure it is there, because I never forget practical hints. Mastitis, very commonly. Frostbites, it is very common remedy. Pyrogen also has tendency to formation of the abscesses. Yes, that no, but in pyrogen there is a septicemia associated. It is not just a superficial infection, it is associated with the blood infection, and at the same time there is one characteristic is that there is in tachycardia as compared to, or it is called as proportional tachycardia. as compared to the temperature. So patient temperature might be 100 and fever pulse rate is nearly 140 or 150. No other remedy matches. It is pyrogen only. So these are practical things one must understand. And these are useful for practice. Generally, in cases the fever which is not decreasing and remains for longer time of duration, always think of the pyrogen. Pyrogen helps a lot in such types of cases. So don't forget pyrogen in such cases. We'll go ahead. One more slide is there with calcareous help. In neuralgia, it occupies ground between very acute pains of MACPAS and the paralyzing ones of Kallifos. In more in aged persons, if there is a want of regenerative force of nervous tissue. This sentence plays very important. So it is not just a neuralgia like a MACPAS. It is associated with paralyzing feeling in between state. Going from MACPAS to Kallifos, the in between state can be covered with the help of a calcareous help. And the last sentence, last paragraph regarding it. In the third stage of inflammation, that is resolution, after going from pus which is having an end and resolution, after Kallimur, this is very important remedy. If the discharge is lumpy and bloody, and if yellow or mucus, Kallisal is one more remedy. So, first there is a Ferampus, second is Kallimur, third is Calcareousal, and followed by Kallisal. If the pus like or if pus like or bloody pus, silica is next other last remedy in this inflammatory stages. So Kallisal followed by silica. In carbuncles, anthracinum is better. Yes, anthracinum is the remedy in generally in this summer season whenever people comes with a lot of boils or recurrent abscesses, anthracinum plays a very vital role. Give intercurrently at least 2 or 3 doses of anthracinum and it helps a lot. It immediately stops the further progress of the disease. Calcareous help is often useful after Kallimur when the latter has but partially relieved, also after Belladonna and other acute remedies. So after first and second stage of inflammation, the role of calcareous help is always there. When well selected remedies act only a short time, calcareous help shares importance with sulfur, tuberculinum, and psoriasis. So, whenever well-selected remedies fail to act or they act for a short time, we know that sulfur is definitely a remedy. There are two more sulfur along with tuberculinum and psoriasis. But Schussler says this is one more remedy. One should not forget this is one important remedy which is very essential in such types of cases. So, this is all about the calcareous help. So, this is the third remedy in relationship we have discussed. We have finished calcarea pleura, calcarea fos, and the calcarea sol. We'll go ahead with the next one, the Ferampus. Ferampus was proved by Jesse Morgan, MD, in 1876. The symptomatology is to be found in Allen's Encyclopedia. The wide extensive usefulness of this drug is entirely owing to the introduction by Schussler. The proving up to the present time do not give sufficient basis for broad clinical applications that have been made of it according to the indications of Schussler, although the provings so far as they have gone support these. So Schussler have made a lot of work regarding the Ferampus and understanding of Ferampus, and that is included in number of books. Administration, fracturations and dilutions from 6x to 12x are recommended by Schussler, although for anemia, much lower treacherous preparations have been used as 1x or 2x. Competent and trustworthy observers have found it advisable not to use this remedy below the 12x at night, as it is exceedingly liable to cause sleeplessness. So that is one practical hint. You should not give it below 12x at specifically at night if patient is suffering from sleeplessness, because it aggravates the sleeplessness. But that is the only hint. I have not seen that in my practice. Its external application is also recommended by Schussler in such diseases as sprains, wounds, hemorrhages, and hemorrhoids. This is also a recommendation by Schussler, but I have not used in my practice. Cures with 200 potency are reported in catarrh, summer complaints, and gonorrhea. Dr. Morgan, the brewer, uses the 30th potency in water for the scarlatina. Now we'll turn towards the relationship because that is more important. Corresponding as it does to the first stage of inflammation, without exudation, its nearest analog is aconite. Yes, exudation comes, is calimur. If there is no exudation and only congestion, first remedy always is an aconite followed by this ferumphosphoricum, then comes the belladonna. So aconite, ferumphos, belladonna, gelsemium, it comes. So this is how we have to think. Yes, he has written over there, rumex contains a large amount of organic iron and is similar to respiratory and digestive symptoms. It stands midway between aconite and gelsemium. Schussler expresses himself as follows in regard to the use of aconite for similar indication. In cases in which vegetable remedy aconite is used for irritation, hyperemia, the basis of first stage of all inflammation, the practice is indirect biochemistry. Regarding the way and the mode in which aconite can bring about a cure, there are two possibilities to be thought of. Either the aconite molecules, which have reached the seat of the disease, serve as a temporary substitute for iron molecules. So he gives the probable explanation how aconite works. There are molecules of aconite substitute for iron molecules, which have ceased to perform their function, but only until the functional disturbance has been repaired by means of vital circulation, or the aconite molecule causes at once the introduction of new iron molecules into the diseased tissue and are themselves has been restored a fate which naturally also would be shared by those aconite molecules which might have served as substitute. So two possibilities that how aconite can work in such types of cases in along with the ferumphos or in spite of ferumphos. Each of these possibilities would rest on indirect biochemistry, the healing, the irritation, hyperemia, however, by means of ferumphos is direct biochemic procedure. So in such types of cases, if you don't have an aconite also, if you have ferumphos, give ferumphos and you can cure that acute first stage of inflammation anywhere present, whether it is present in throat, whether it is present in nose, whether it is present in eyes, anywhere. If such a thing happens, it is better to give and better to start with the ferumphosphoricum and see the results with the patients. Okay, last part of this, I think one or two parts are there. Aconite has more bounding pulse. See, this is very important again. Clinical verification. Aconite has a more bounding pulse and characteristic restlessness and anxiety. That we know, that restlessness, tossing about in aconite, agony, fear, phobia, everything. Gelsemium, more soft flowing pulse. See, this is the clinical verification. Aconite chip pulse is bounding us there because it is because there is a lot of phobia, a lot of fear, a lot of excitement, turmoil, and that's why with palpitation, pulse is always very bounding. Whereas gelsemium is dull, dizzy, drowsy. And as gelsemium is dull, dizzy, drowsy, the pulse becomes soft, flowing pulse, and with more drowsiness and dullness. And that's the differentiation at the clinical level. Try to apply this with the patients. Try to compare it with the patients. And then you will learn remedy by more and more depth. In anemic conditions, compare also the China, with which it has many symptoms in common. It is interesting to note that the tree from which China is obtained is always found in a ferruginous locality. So ferruginous locality means jithe ferum khup jasta pramanat aahe asha tikani China plant vadto. So it contains a ferumphosphoricum inside it, and because of it, it also cures the anemia. See, this is the study of the Schussler, who gives the details about it and which is very essential. In its action upon the respiratory organs, it clearly stands between the iron and phosphorus. Like ferum, it is indicated in congestion of the respiratory organs even when there is a considerable fever. Especially notice that the oppression and dyspnea, both of which are extremely marked in ferum and phosphoricum, are duplicated in this compound and afford good indications for its use. So in general way, symptoms of operation like phosphorus should be treated with this drug. So if there are symptoms of perum on one side and phosphorus on one side, both are expressing over there, think of a synthetic prescription. This is called as a synthetic prescription. If in your case is showing on one side the calcarea features and another side the sulfur features, if you repertorize, you get the calcarea along with the sulfur. You never get the calcarea sulfur there in repertorization. But logically, if you synthesize them, think synthetically and give a calcarea sulfur, it works. This aspect is called as a making a synthetic prescription. And sometimes this is very useful when you are not getting result with plain calcarea or plain sulfur or plain iron or plain phosphorus. Think of such a synthetic prescription and it helps a lot in your practice. So this is what he is explaining over there, that if you have iron features and phosphorus features, think of a perum pos and which covers the whole aspect of the case. One more slide is there and this is very important. Perum pos corresponds in many points also to bryonia, belladonna and arnica and to heparin and mercury, especially in acute inflammations of the middle ear. So otitis media, this is very important remedy where the pain, I have explained that pain associated with discharge of plastic exudate, perum pos along with kalimur plays very vital role. In the debility, loss of strength and vitality of the children, it is the remedy of the flesh to be firm, complexion delicate, hair light and curly. But the sulfur takes its place in dark complexion and dark complexion children with flabby muscles, long and lank hair and moist skin. See, this is the difference which he has very clearly explained. That in case of perum pos, the complexion is delicate, hairs are light and curly. But if you consider the sulfur for the such and similar case, debility, loss of strength and vitality in children, the sulfur children are the dark complexion children with flabby muscles, long and lank hair instead of curly hairs in perum pos and moist. These are clinical observations done by these people, and these clinical observations helps in your practice again and again. So make a note, make a habit of writing all those notes, and not only write that, just go through it again and again so that it becomes fixed in your mind and you can apply whenever patient is there in front of you. In the rheumatic affections of the aged, when the muscles are stiff and weakened, see, in the old people, muscles are becoming stiff and weak with a disposition to the painful cramps, compare strychnine phosphoricum. See, this is very important remedy, which generally are no one considers. But what he gives, rheumatic affections of the aged, where muscles are stiff and weakened, with disposition to painful cramps, compare strychnine phosphoricum. California Zinfandel wine, a pure carved claret, a product of wine growing in volcanic virgin soil, strongly impregnated with iron, and possesses virtues in cases of anemic tendencies, probably due to the iron soil on which it grows. After perum pos is frequently indicated, kalimur, especially in diphtheria, in pneumonia, Krauf, etc., often also the kalisar. So in such conditions, whenever Krauf is there, diphtheria is there, pneumonia is there, in such types of conditions, there is a generally a discharge happens to be there. So a pain along with a discharge, and discharge not if it is not suppurative, you must think of perum pos with kalimur. If it is suppurative, you can go with the kalisal also. So in this way, you have to apply your logic in order to learn all those remedies. So this remedy relationship with other homeopathic remedies, one must understand thoroughly. So we have learned regarding the perum pos. The last slide regarding perum pos, these are again practical hints which he mentioned. In chlorosis, follow or precede calcarea pos. I will suggest that you must give perum pos plus calcarea pos plus natramur and that is anemia combination, number one biocombination, which contains all three things. The perampos is there, the karyopos is there, and natriumur is there. It is very important remedy in such types of cases. In hemorrhoids, calcarea pleur, one should think of calcarea pleur. That also already we have learned. In diabetes, compare it with natrum sulfuricum. In bronchopneumonia, why diabetes natrum sulfuricum? Because it is a psychotic element. Remedy, natrum sulf is king of antipsychotic. And diabetes is very clearly covered under the natrum sulf. Bronchopneumonia, tartar emetic. Tartar emetic means anti-tart. So close relationship between perampos and tartar emetic, because there is rattling cough in both remedies. In ear affections, catarrhal deafness, calendula and hydrastis. See, these are two important remedies. Again, one should not forget. Hydrastis and calendula along with the perampos. And last, one more indication. In headaches, natrumphos often follows well. But if you are thinking of the natrumphos, always think that there must be a yellowish coating on the tongue or discharges if there are any. They are of completely golden yellow color. And it is with severe acid peptic trouble. So we have finished two more remedies. First, we have started with the calcarea sulf, and then we have continued with the perampos. One more remedy we have to finish today, the relationship, and that is nothing but the kalimuraticum. So instead of going to the kalimur, what we'll do, we will conclude this session and we'll join it again, because very soon less time is remaining, otherwise it disturbs. So I will ask Vinod to conclude the meeting and rejoin again. I will ask to rejoin again. We'll learn this kalimur and followed by one more biocombination, how to use that biocombination in your practice. So that will be one more part of today's session. And next remedy, I think we'll start it tomorrow, because that remedy is very important and very common remedy in day-to-day practice is Kali Phosphoricum. So instead of going for Kali Phos today, we'll have full session tomorrow for the Kali Phos. So join it again. Vinod, close the session and join again.
Yes, sir.